I have always held, and you have understood it. And anyway, everybody is a good astrologer. He knows everything. But my way of thinking is, unless our basics are firm, it is really difficult to build a structure which is stable on it. So I have chosen to spoke about Bhava and Bhavesha and their importance in analysis of astrological charts. So we will begin with trying to understand what is Bhava, what does it mean. So Pallav, if you can take the next. So the Bhava originates from the root Bhu, which means being, arising, existing, and it has many meanings. Word Bhava itself, it is true condition or state, truth, reality, really, truly, place of birth, the womb, and any state of mind or body, way of thinking, feelings, sentiments, opinion, disposition, intention, perception. So this perception and intention also has to be kept in mind when we talk about Bhava. Those who are Hindi speakers, we say Bhavana. I have such a Bhavana about XYZ. I feel, or my perception. We say Sad Bhavana. We have got good feelings about somebody. Isn't it? So this is Bhavana. And then the next slide, we shall see what are the synonyms and what is the importance of Bhava. So Kalyan Varma, in his great text Saravali, has said, Ruksham Bhavana Namani Rashihi Kshetram Bha Mevatva Uktani Purva Munni Bhi Stulyartha Pratipatte. That means Ruksha, Rashi, Bhavana, Kshetra, Bha are all synonyms for Bhava. Because what happens is, generally we try to differentiate between Rashi and Bhava. There is a difference between them. There is no doubt, because Rashi always represents a 2 1/4 part of Nakshatras, which is true, but they also cover the gamut of Bhava, or what is the perception of a person about something, about which we will go later on. Why I chose Bhava or Bhavana is because then he goes on to say, Bhavana adhipaye samastam jataka vihitam vichantaye matimana. The intelligent have to think about the Lord of the Bhavas. Evirvina na shakyam padam apigantu mahashastra. In this great science of astrology, one cannot move even 1 foot unless we understand the Bhavana and Bhavana adhipa. Because Bhavana adhipa is dual. So it is the Lord of the Bhava and the Bhava itself. And this is why I think we should go, rather, I was trying to talk about Bhava and Bhavana, the complex subject already, the great ones I already explained to you. So we will go to the next slide, dear Pallav. And so the question is, Bhava is perception, we understand. From whose point of view? This is one thing one has to understand. See, the Tanu Bhava is the body of the Jataka, everybody knows that, about that we will come in the later part of this lecture, which is called the Tanu Bhava or the Lagna Bhava. So, of the Jataka. And it is his perception of those Bhavas which are also to be understood. We generally, when I was very young, I used to look at a chart and think of what sort of father would he have or what sort of mother he would have from looking at the ninth or the fourth Bhava. But we have to understand, even the Jataka's own assessment about himself and our assessment about him would be different. So this has to be looked from both the point of views. That is why Bhava is very important. Like, for an example, you know, different siblings might think differently about their own parents. The samskara are same, the family is same, but their understanding of what sort of parent they have might be different. Same happens about their own siblings. One sibling might rever his brother, and the brother may not be very happy with the younger one, or vice versa. Similarly, we may think a person is wealthy, he might think that he is not wealthy or he is not earning enough, which question I am sure most of you must have come across when a jataka tends to ask, hum kitna kamayenge, kitna jyada kama sakte hai, how much I will earn. And a millionaire wants to know when he will earn in billions. And maybe somebody who earns in thousands would like to know when he will be able to earn tens of thousands. So you have to understand it is his perception about his own capabilities, about his own relatives as represented with the bhava. And its meaning is truth. One of the meanings of bhava is truth. Now, whose truth is also to be understood? See, the same bhava will be perceived by the jataka in a different person. People looking at the jataka or looking at his life would look at it from a different point of view. And this is something I think we must try to decrypt, if I can say, analyze and find out what might be the truth. As a matter of fact, as an astrologer, we should try to find out the truth, because many a times you must have experienced that when Jataka comes to you, you ask him something, in the first instance, he might even deny or may forget and not tell you. And the whole problem is, the most important of bhava is the tanu bhava, because everything is with respect to this tanu bhava. That is with respect to the jataka himself also. I mean, his view of looking at things, how he perceives things, and how he perceives is one of the factors which, because he perceives in his mind, and our dasha, especially the Vinshottari dashas, derive from a position of moon. So his perception of mind can tell us what is happening in a particular bhava at a particular time due to relative position of the planets in the natal chart, in transits, and in the dashas. So this is how we actually come to a conclusion, or what we call we predict. So we shall go to the next slide. Pallava has already done it. Then this is symbolic. We know this is all, ultimately the planets are in the zodiac. They are against the backdrop of the nakshatras, and that is how we come to what we call Rashi or Namansha or Nakshatrapada and whatever. So they, in a way, are symbolic. But why Bhavana is said? Sometimes it is also called Gruha. I'm sure, I need not tell this to the astrologers, but just for the sake of making a point clear. Why is it called house in English? They generally call it house, we call it bhava. We also call it bhavana. Bhavana also means house. The idea is to make it clear the dependence, interdependence of bhava and bhavesha. Because bhava, understanding only bhava and not understanding the bhavesha, might make us a bit confused while analyzing a chart. That has to be understood. So the allegory or symbolism, as you call it, is pretty simple to understand. See, if a house is well built, is strong, long lasting, by implication, the owner of the house would have some authority, he would be financially fine, and go the reverse way. If the house is dilapidated, naturally, vice versa apply, so the lord would become weak. So now, where does this come into picture? We are not interested in what is the house lord. This indicates that strength of bhava will strengthen the bhavesh, the lord of the bhava. And using certain words in Hindi or Sanskrit so that everybody understands it. And if bhavesha is strong, even if a bhava is weak, this strong bhavesha will impart some strength to the bhava itself. Now this has to be understood properly so that we never make a mistake. Many a times what happens, a bhava is damaged. And we can immediately, especially when I was young, I used to do that. So I'm sure the novices would do that. The experienced astrologers might not. But then we would think that everything is gone by this person. So what are the tools that we use? Normally, basic tools that we use is planets, the Rashis, the karakas. This is a very important tool. We will talk about it in connection with bhava also. Then bhavas, mahadashas, and transfers. These are the basic tools to time an event, to understand the general, what I can call it, the personality of a jataka, and also try to fix the lagna, whether the lagna is correct. See, all this while you will understand, since bhava is concerned and bhava is related to the jataka, who is represented by the lagna, it is very natural that unless lagna is fixed, other things that we talk about, we may go awry. This would happen especially when the lagna is either in the early degree or the late degree, where maybe 5 or 10 minutes of difference of birth that is noted would change the entire picture. And many a times astrologers could get confused why the principles that are told to us are not coming into fact or not applied to this particular jataka. Check his lagna whether it is right or wrong. Then a bit more advanced tools that are there are Arudha, which is a reflection which comes out of the Bimba Pratibimba theory or principle from Kapil Muni's Sankhya Yoga. Argalas, Ashtaka Varga, Sudarshan Chakra, these are somewhat advanced tools. You go ahead. I mean, if you have got the base, you understand the basic tools. That is why I said I would rather talk about some basic subject. If you understand basic tools properly, then the other tools you can anyway by implication understand what they are. Whether you want to use them or not is your decision, your criteria, your sense of proportion, whatever you want, or how much time you have got in your hand. And the tools needed for detailed, which need detailed calculations and accuracy of birth time would be the charakarakas. When you want to find out how many degrees the planet has advanced, why I am telling you, I'll tell in 2 minutes. Then Shodasha Vargas, Varga charts as we call it, or Varga Kundali as it is called in colloquial language, and dashas calculated up to Deha Dasha level. Nadi Amshas, all these need detailed calculation. So why am I more fixated on the basics? The reason is, when I was young, I have seen great astrologer P. S. Shastri was from our city of Nagpur. H. N. Katwe was also from Nagpur. They used to come and discuss with my father, so I know a bit of how they would do. And there were many. When P. S. Shastri was there, and so many. But in those days, the system was you give a small piece of paper on which only Rashi chart is written. And people used to come with it and ask the astrologer to predict. And I have seen them giving many a times wonderful predictions. Like every predictive science, there is always a possibility of some failure. 10 to 20% failure is not a great failure. That happens across every science, even the finite sciences like engineering that we practice. Or medical science, which is still not able to understand the coronavirus, which is going on anyway. So, how to get rid of it? Because other viruses, they already developed vaccines. So, how could they do it is something one has to understand. My understanding was they were, see, every astrologer in those days, first thing they would do in the morning is to take up the almanac, the Panchanga, read it, find out the transit position. The Janmanam was always given on the basis of the Nakshatra Pada, the name at birth. And the Prachalita, as this is the name that was used to talk about that person, would be something else. That Janmanam, the specific name, secret name, let us put it that way, at birth, was based on the Nakshatra Charana. And that is how it was given. So the moment the person would come, they would say, what is your Janmanam, knowing the Namasha? They would know the approximate Mahadasha. Transits they would know, and the chart was there. I think the basic tool that they used was a very deep understanding of the Bhava-Bhava relationship and how the placement of Bhava lords in different Bhavas work. And that is why I am always a follower of a simplified system, the basic systems. And what is the great importance of Bhava is there is a saying, Indu Sarvatra Bijabho, Lagnam Chak Kusumak Prabha. The chart and its results are seen in the form of a fruit-bearing tree. So what the sage is saying is, Indu, that is moon. Moon is the seed of everything. This is very easy to understand because moon rules our mind. Chandrama Manaso Jataha, we call it in Purusha Supta, if I remember right. And because of what we think, we take some action, which action then leads to the results. Isn't it? So we is always the mind. Whether I will work in such a fashion or some different fashion will depend on what I feel in my mind and the action is taken. Lagnam cha kusuma prabha. Lagna is tanubhava, the body of the jataka, through which what comes into mind is expressed in real life. So lagna, the tanubhava, I would call it tanubhava or lagna bhava every time. So to make understand that lagna itself is the primary bhava, the important bhava. He is like the flower. Always, you know, fruits, before something fruits, it flowers. There is a flowering. So lagna is like that flower. So it has now created something. Phalena sadrusha vanshascha. Then the fruit comes. That fruit is nothing but navamsha. Navamsha is like the fruit. See, which gives body to this action of that person, let us put it. And bhava swadu rasa smrita. The nectar is bhava. So to analyze a chart and get the nectar out of it, which is the extract of it, I would say. Remember that bhava is very important. This is what the sages have said. Now, if we go to the next slide, the question is how to extract the nectar from the bhava. So we have to utilize the bhava principles. We need to understand the basic and very important principle. Our Lord gives its own results. They say, bhava ka Lord dusre bhav ke ashray se apne phal deta hai. That means a bhava Lord delivers his results by taking shelter of the bhava that he occupies. So the expression would be through the bhava that he occupies. For example, the best example I can perhaps give, and you can test it in the charts that you will come across in the time of practice of astrology that you are all doing, and when advising people, if Lagna Lord say is placed in the sixth bhava. Now the sixth bhava is the bhava of enemies, litigation, relatives, hard work, job, everything. You will generally find that person is his own enemy. His own actions hurt him. Because where from the personality of that person will express itself? From the enemy bhava. Go reverse. If sixth Lord goes to the lagna bhava, what happens? It is a bhava of disease. So, the tanu bhava will get disease, means the bodily health issues could be there for the jataka if the sixth Lord is occupying the lagna. I mean, I can go on, but paucity of time and discipline stops me from doing that. We will look at it at the end of the... I'll only give one example. So, what about the relation between the bhava and the bhava Lord? Again, we go back to synonym of bhava, and we know that symbolic, you know, way it is expressed. So, they have to be looked at, bhava and bhavesha, like landlord and the house itself, and their strengths matter. Now, how do we go about it would be another question. If we can go to the next slide, please. We will first look at how even nadis look at lagna bhava. Because the people think that parashari is something different and jaimini is something different. I am of a different opinion. Even nadis are something, I have a bit of different opinion, but However, there are so many nadis. There is mantra nadi, there is that copper plate nadi, which I think now he has stopped writing, I mean, reading from it. And then there are those nadi patras, where they ask you all details of your relatives and then finalize. And then there is Chandrakala Nadi. This is from Guru Nadi, one of the texts which was handwritten. I got it through Sunil John of Saptarshi Astrology. He had got it from the great Chandubhai Patel, C.S. Patel. It was not translated, so I translated some of the shlokas from it. So what does it say? Eta Vaya Samakhyata Proktaya Brahmanapura. See, this has been told by Lord Brahma in ancient time. Nadi Samajnayavarno Shakyo Lagna Nirnaya. Unless you rationalize the results of Nadi with the whatever the Jataka says, his Lagna cannot be fixed. And if Lagna cannot be fixed, whatever, avidnyate punar Lagna. Remember, again, that if Lagna is not, Mrushadeva Vinyase. So, without knowing the Lagna, what you say might not come true. Tasman Nadi Parikshaiva Kurya Jataka Nirnaya. So, check the Nadi, what the Nadi says about his relatives, his profession and whatever, and then come to a conclusion whether the Lagna is correct. And then go to the predictive part of the whatever is written in the Nadi, which in case of the other Nadi, the Vaidyanath Koil type of Nadis which are there, you know about them. Those leaves, they go on turning and asking you questions. But this happens everywhere. The reason is because in the Chandrakala Nadis and other type of Nadis, it is hardly a 12-second arc which is taken. And so the results are different, you will see when you read the Chandrakala Nadi. So now we go ahead and see whether any other Nadi talks about it. So Chandrakala Nadi tells us, Chandra Lagnam Sharirasya, Lagnam Syat Pran Sandat, Teva Parikshaiva Sarva Nadi Phalasva. To understand the results of all the Nadis that are given, because Chandrakala Nadi is one, it talks about, Lagna Nadi and Guru Nadi and Bhrugu Nadi and others, so they are all to be read together. Most of them have not been translated, except Chandrakala Nadi, which was done by the great Santanamsa. And he said, Chandra Lagna is only body. What puts the prana? Prana is the life force in this sharira, is Lagna. And without analyzing both, it would not be correct to talk about the results of Nadi. So you have to bring together all Nadis, find out what they say about a person, and then come to a conclusion whether the Lagna belongs to this Jataka, and then go ahead. That is why I am talking about Lagna. I can talk about every bhava, but paucity of time and the fact that you are already a learned person makes me make it short. The most important is Lagna. We look at it from Lagna perspective. We are aware of that. And so I am making it very clear that all those things are similar. There are so many tools. You can use few tools and still come to near correct analysis. So what has to be done? What about the house? What do we do? How to assess the strength? It's simple. Everybody knows it actually. When a bhava is aspected by Jupiter or Mercury or lord of that bhava itself, then the bhava gains strength is more. The next part the sages have not said, because logically it is very obvious that if a bhava is aspected by other planets, this strength will get modified. If by natural malefics, the aspect on the bhava is by natural malefic, the bhava will get weak, I would say. The strength would be reduced. The extent depending on the planet which is aspecting. So, if the bhava is strong, then the lord of the bhava also gets strength. This has to be understood. Many a time the lord is weak and there is a tendency of thinking that the person is weak. Even the vice versa will happen. So implication is simple, that if bhava is strong, the bhava will be strength. If bhava is weak, it will weaken the bhava. Obviously, a weak bhava lord will also weaken the bhava. And strong bhava lord will also strengthen the bhava, even if it is weakened because of aspect of other planets or position of some planet in that bhava, is to be understood. So we have to use this very skillfully. First, you have to fix Lajman, which could be either through Nadi, Amsha, or results attributed to it, or the person who is sitting in front of you, or the persona of the Jataka, like how he looks, whether he is keeping steady or moving sometimes like me, or is always in perpetual motion, what sort of hair he has, his body structure, because we know all those things from the basic tools themselves. And once that is fixed, his temper, his steadiness, his relations with siblings, because I like to go by the finite things which we can verify, like relations with siblings, parents, his education. These things are very easy and they cannot be fudged. If I ask somebody if you have a temper, in most likelihood he will say, I don't have temper. But sometimes, in the next thing comes, sometimes I speak the truth in a harsh manner, which means he has temper. But generally, people, before they trust you as an astrologer, would not tell that. If the child is sick, when he was very young, is very easy to see. Moon in the 6, 8 or 12 aspected by malefics would indicate that. So these are the tools which are available to us. Even the Jaimini says, Shukrena Vyavahita Garbhana Ashaha. So Venus in 11th or the 3rd, or even the 8th house, some say, even the Lajna, indicates that mother has suffered one abortion. These are the tools available. These have to be used skillfully to fix them. Once Lajna is fixed, then we go ahead. So the next slide, if you may follow. So as I have already spoken, all other bhavas relate to the Lajna. Once we fix the Lajna, then next tool that we have to use is the placement of the bhava in different bhava, so that we come near to the right analysis. Even if birth chart is not exact. See, nowadays I see this and it's not wrong. Everybody insists on absolutely correct birth time. The problem is, if I remember right, Narada had said that birth time is so small, so minuscule. It is as if you pierce a lotus leaf with a needle. The time it takes to get pierced, that is the time of birth. And that is Kutam Manusha, etc., etc. He says, Brahmana Janati, even the Lord Brahma doesn't know, how can human being? This is what the great Narada said. And the process of birth and our, when we talk about, you know, I'm extremely sorry, I mean, I don't mean this is. See, going for accuracy is correct. There is no doubt about it. But we must examine ourselves first. We are not yet sure which ayanamsha to use. By now, there are 5 or 6 ayanamshas which are talked about. That would change these sputas, the Lagna sputa and every sputa. We are not sure what is the birth time. Some say when the head is seen. Some say when the umbilical cord is cut. I even seen some people saying when a baby falls on the earth, which never happens, it cannot. It comes in a packed in a amniotic fluid sac. So we must understand that there are so many things which are different and which can make a difference in the Lagna proper. Once Lagna is gone, then everything is gone. And our sages were, you know, intelligent enough to know that in any analytical tool, there has to be some scope for error. What in engineering we call plus minus 5, plus minus 10. So here we are given a window of almost 2 hours. Actually, 2 hours happens only on the equator, but as we go towards Mars, the time would be minimized, but there is plenty of time. And since these bhavas are truth, something which you can view with your eyes or understand after asking somebody whether XYZ thing had happened or not, why not fix the lagna and go ahead from that? Even in Vinshottari Dasha or any Dasha, there is such a huge difference of opinion whether to use Savan 360 Savan days or 360 solar days or 365.2529 days as a year, which would make a huge difference in Dashas also. So the best tool available to us is the Bhava-Bhavesha relationship and the results that are likely for the Jataka because of placement of one Bhava Lord in another Bhava. And what he can deliver from that Bhava, if we assess that, then we may be near accuracy. I would not say 100% accuracy. Nobody has 100% accuracy. If I remember right, then I think Nilakantha has said something that Brahma went to Vishnu and carried his own chart and asked him what is going to happen and all that. So, and even Parashara says about certain things that Garga Dina Mata, that Garga and others have different opinion. I have different opinion. Isn't it? So ultimately, why we are doing this? We are doing it, according to me, to advise a Jataka. Jataka generally comes to you when he has problems. Nobody comes to a doctor or an astrologer when he has no problems. Unless he is your friend, of course, he will come. But generally, they don't. He is in problem. Now, how can that problem be solved? We know karma is the one tool which is given to you. About that, Lord Krishna has talked at length in Bhagavad Gita, where he also used the astronomy part of it very skillfully, but this is not the forum for that. So, karma phala we are going to get. In last birth, whatever karma has happened. We can't go back into the last birth to rectify it. But at least in this life, we can do certain things which would at least minimize the negatives. And an astrologer can suggest that, looking at that chart and analyzing the bhava-bhavesha position and what is likely to happen. I always take astrology as a potential. Those who are engineers will understand the potential energy and kinetic energy. And that potential can only be realized through karma. If the time is bad, you can even ask him to keep quiet for some time till the negative period is passed. Because transits are working and they do have their own impact on what is likely to happen. And once that happens, we are through. What happens many a times is I have seen yogas are there, results are not obtained. So one has also to think in which bhava the yoga is happening. Say, if, for example, what example can I give? Mars and Moon together, generally called the Lakshmi Yoga, are occupying the 12th house. The 12th house is not only house of sleep, house of death and whatever, and moksha and expenditure. It is also house of distant lands. So perhaps that yoga is placed in distant land. So this Jataka better go there to obtain it. Isn't it? This is how we can use the information that is given to us very nicely and in a very simplistic manner by the sages. We also must remember there is also a role of Karaka. Though this is not the stage nor the time for explaining Karaka, but you remember even Bhavad Bhava principle is there. How do you know what is going to happen to the third daughter of your younger uncle if you don't understand Bhavas? And Bhavad Bhava principle, because assuming that her chart is not available to you, you will go to the father's house, that is 5th, and then from that third house is 11th. And from that, you will find 5 and then 7 and 9th houses. And there will be the third daughter of the younger brother of your father, who is your uncle, isn't it? And then you analyze that house to get some result about it, because sometimes in emergency, this happens. And people come to astrologer with a great expectation that he will help them somehow or other. that doesn't mean you can make a dead or walk. That's not our problem, but you can certainly tell what is a bad time, what is a good time. Similarly, there is something called Karakan Bhava principle, which we many a times tend to forget. I used to forget when I was young and got scolded. So it's not that, I mean, forgetting is normal. We know that the great Parashara also said, in case of father, look also from ninth from son, because son is the Karaka for the ninth Bhava. Again, Karaka of the Bhava is being talked about. Remember that. Son himself is Karaka for father, but he is also Karaka for the ninth Bhava, which also represents father. Then from moon, the fourth house should be analyzed for mother. Again, moon is the Karaka for the fourth house, which is also house of the mother. Then you can even extend it further if you want. But this not being the problem. And so on, you know, relatives, Mars, third from Mars can also be seen for what is happening to the siblings. So Bhavas form a very important position in analysis of astrology in depth. Then you have got other tools which you can always use, which is transits, the dasha orders. But if Lagna is not fixed, your Bhavas are not fixed. Since Bhavas are not fixed, where a Bhavasha is placed and how he will give result through that Bhava is also not understood. And many a times that is why people say ki yoga is there and it is not fructifying, but look where that yoga is happening. It may be happening in some place where the Jataka is placed and the yoga may be happening at some other place, isn't it? Like 10th Lord in 6th house or 6th Lord in 10th house. See, general understanding is if a Bhava Lord goes to 6th, that Bhava is destroyed. Or vice versa, if 6th, 8th or 12th Lords go to the 10th house, then the Bhava is destroyed, so he would not do well. But remember that 6th house is also house of hard work. So he can get out of it if he works hard. This is something we must learn. That is why Bhava and Bhavesh subject I have chosen to make. I can't say understand because you are all learned people. I mean, I am nobody in front of your knowledge, but I think this is how we go about Bhava and Bhava principle. And the next slide, I will try to tell something about it. This is only I am taking two charts. I don't like example charts because in practice we don't get those same charts repeated. The walk-in charts are absolutely different. But here, you have got a great example of what I was saying. First chart is chart of Queen Victoria. Lord of the second, placed in the 12th house, is a typical Daridra Yoga. I am sure everybody knows it. People are very interested either in yoga for wealth or for penury. Because those who have wealth are scared that penury will catch him sometimes, catch them unawares. So, what happened with Queen Victoria? If you go through the history, you will understand. Britain was under great pressure from Spain and was on the verge of, you know, financial collapse. Victoria said, go out and fight those Spanish people. And then she went on expanding her empire outside. This is the 12th house. A lot of the lagna, a lot of the wealth sitting in the 12th house. Where is the wealth located? In the 12th house. If that is not sought, what happens? You become a pauper. So it is not that the Daridra Yoga is wrong. But that can be skillfully converted into a yoga of wealth. So Victoria had her empire all over the world. And all money used to come from the colonies. Read through the history and you will find that what I am saying is not wrong. That is how her wealth used to come. Not from anywhere. Everything used to come from colonies. Colonies supplies were stopped and then England would reprocess that thing and export it back. So this is Queen Victoria's chart. Now, of course, it is Rajyoga. That is why she was a queen. So then what happened? George V came. Then came Elizabeth II. Look at her chart. Here also you will find Saturn, Lord of the Second, is in the 12th house. Identical thing, again Daridra Yoga. What happened with Queen Elizabeth? Now she is also being asked to pay taxes, if I remember right, by the British. The British Empire collapsed totally. They wanted to do it on their own. gave up the colonies. So no income from outside. And if you have read Economic Times of today, you will find many of the British companies are closing down. Ireland wants to separate out of it. An empire always said, never used to say, that is what was taught to us when we were young and we were learning. Now they don't even know when sun rises and when sun sets. So this is how the penury comes into picture. Same yoga, Lord of the Second in the 12th house. Wealth being expended or wasted. But if you take that same 12th house as a distant land, then the same person can earn wealth from this 12th house. 12th house is house of reputation and recognition going to the 12th house. So people may think that I am not appreciated, but they would be appreciated in distant land or different land. So this is all about Bhava and Bhavesh relationship and the importance of Bhava and how to extract the nectar from the seed, you know, planted by the moon, the mind, and what arises out of it. So, thank you.